contract.
Come in, Todd.
Hello, Todd. Okay, this is the shot. The fort's under attack. You're standing in front of a door. You see an arrow sail over the wall. It's sailing right at you. So you act out the moment where you see the arrow, and it smashes through your head. Okay? Ready? Action. Good cut. So, I want to see it again, this time in slow motion.
Slow motion.
Yes.
Actually grew up here in Columbus, went to junior high here, went to high school here, went to the Ohio State mm-hmm. University. And got my Bachelor of Fine Arts degree at Ohio State. Warm weather, that was appealing going out to the West Coast, and I don't know, I was always fascinated with television and film, and I knew that was the place to be, so I thought getting a good training in theater and then and being able to have that training and using that out in Hollywood for television and film. I seemed to go through these phases of where I was a cop for like 10 years. I have this Midwestern all-American look, and it's like, yes. You know, I kind of fell into the cop mm-hmm. uniform for a while. So I did a film, Adam's Family Reunion, with Tim Curry and Daryl Hannah. That was a great experience, mm-hmm. and I played a cop in that. Played a cop on General Hospital for 2 summers. I was always like the cop that let something happen, you know, it was like the cliffhanger, and I let Luke into the family reunion. He caused all the havoc.
Plus aggravated assault,
yeah.
Attempted murder, and maybe even a successful murder.
It's no good either. It's no good, this. Trigger's been set to permanent default.
We are still looking for the nuclear device.
Maybe we should call his wife, verify his story.
What's your phone number?
Excuse me. Are you here for the auction?
Me, yes. Take another look. Are you absolutely sure he's not up there?
I wish I could help you, but the guy got me from behind. I never saw him.
I was actually at Ohio State University back in the mid-80s, and John Kuhn was in the master's program when I was there. So we did a couple of shows at Ohio State, and then Oberlin, which I talked about earlier, he was actually there a summer, and we worked together in a show up there together. So. And like I say, when I was in California, I'd come back, and I always knew John was involved in doing things here, and then in Actors Theater, I always saw his name, and I thought, you know, if I ever get back to Columbus, that's something that I would like to try to pursue. And just been here a year now, and last summer came and saw Treasure Island. That was the first production that I saw, and there was 1,000 people there that night. It was unbelievable. It was like there was an energy in the crowd. The show was really great. Everybody had a good time. It was a full moon. And I thought, wow, outdoor theater here in Columbus. I thought, you know what, I'd like to be a part of this sometime. And so the opportunity presented itself this last year. John called and said that there was a couple opportunities in 2 of the shows that he was directing. And so I loved playing Armand and Scarlet Pimpernel, which was the first production.
Yes.
And then and Creon in Oedipus Rex, which was the final production in August. So had a great time performing in the park this year.
On board?
We ought to wait, Hanko. We've seen half an hour.
Half an hour? Half an hour more and you'll be far from me, dear brother. Well, I can't believe that you are going. These last few days while Percy has been away and I've had you all to myself, it's about like a dream.
I am not going far, sweet one. A narrow channel to cross, a few miles of road. I can soon come back.
You would?
In any case, be my own brave sister, who would remember that when France is in peril, it is not for her sons to turn their backs on it.
No, Armand.
What news have you brought from the gods?
Good news!
I tell you that even troubles hard to bear will end in perfect peace if they find the right issue.
But what is the oracle? So far your words neither frighten nor encourage me.
If you want to hear in the presence of these people,
the matter,
I am ready to speak. By banishing the man, or by paying back bloodshed with bloodshed, since it is this blood which brings the tempest on our
land, the god said. What is sought for can be caught. Only that which is not watched escapes. Why not rank as third peer of you two?
It is just in this you are bound to be false.
Not so! If you would reason with your heart as I do with mine, weigh this first. Whether you think anyone would choose to rule amid terrors rather than in unruffled peace, granted that he is to have the same power.
I actually worked with Patrick Stewart in 1986. That was at Oberlin. He played Prospero in a production of The Tempest, and I was Trinculo in that production. And we had a wonderful summer together. His birthday is right around 4th of July, and I know we got some fireworks to let off for him. And I'll never forget looking over at him, and when he was looking at the fireworks, it was like a child just beaming at, you know, it was like, and it was his birthday, so it was just a great celebration. And I asked him about that one time, and he said that's how he just stays open, even in his acting, of looking at everything like it's the first time, and always keeping that kind of child in you. Happiness. That's why I'm here, with my family. So as far as other things to do, I have a wonderful wife, Lisa, that supports me in everything that I do. So I feel like Bull Durham, you know, where he said, you know, I got to play the show. He got to play the show. I went to LA for 26 years, you know, and got to do a lot of great things out there. I got to work with a lot of wonderful people. I learned a lot. And like I said before, priorities change, and my bucket list was to be back with my family. Mm-hmm. So that's what I'm doing here, and able to do theater. So I'm happy right now, and just open to whatever can come up in the future.